Okay, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to the second women's semi-final of the day. We have Tanvi Khanna from India up against second seed Hana Moataz from Egypt. Joining me today, Owen Taylor. How are you doing, Owen?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks, Andrew. Just coming off the back of that very impressive performance from Todd in the second men's semi-final.
Yeah, really, I thought it was impressive. Yeah, it was impressive in the fourth. It's pretty, very similar to what we saw yesterday. A good control around the middle and took it in nice and well. Plenty of variations.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how he follows that through into the final. But yeah, for now we've got this match starting. The semi-final earlier with the Egyptian battle won by Malik Kamal. Seemed she followed on that vein of form she was hitting yesterday of just taking everything in short and pretty much hitting everything she went for.
Yeah, she was. She didn't mess around. Although I thought Ismail played well in parts. She obviously played well in the first and got herself back into it in the fourth, but just can't let up with Kamal. You know, she just has such an ability to rattle off points, and I think it's going to be pretty similar for Hana Moataz. She also has that ability to just wrap up points nice and quickly. Although I feel that Tanvi Khanna is a pretty good mover, and she might be able to put these balls back onto the front wall, meaning that Hannah's going to have to be ready to hit a couple more shots than she probably has done so far in this event.
Yeah, I mean, Hannah hasn't spent longer than 20 minutes on court so far in any of her matches, so she's obviously going to be coming into this extremely fresh.
She's not messing around here either. She's straight onto anything that's just left a little bit short, cutting in that nice backhand volley drop.
Yeah, I think she's set out her stall early here, isn't she? And she's not taking any prisoners. She's going straight in. First opportunity of the rally, taking it in short.
Straight through to a quick 6-love lead without really giving Khanna any chance to settle at the moment. That's a fantastic length through to the back of the court. It's pretty impressive so far. It's just rattled through the first 7 points.
Yeah, absolutely blistering start here. Stroke there, perhaps giving Khanna an in into this game.
Well, I thought she was going to volley that then. Just looked like he had a good opportunity for a volley, but decided against it. I felt that was definitely a let minimal from that camera angle. Yeah. She's definitely up behind her very quickly.
I'm not sure if it was the camera angle or, yeah, like you say, we seem to be getting all the wrong decisions currently, yeah. Don't we? But
yeah. It was a good shot from Khanna, because Moataz went for the cross-court nick and she just guided it into that front nick. Oh, she's got herself back in here.
Yeah, I think that's where she's going to have success here. She's going to be having to be the counterpuncher in this game, I think, seeing as how aggressive the Egyptian player is.
Yeah, I would agree with you there. She's going to have to just keep absorbing a little bit first before she gets an opportunity. I think she wants to try and be competitive here. She's done well because this was 7-love within very quick time and she's pulled it back to 5-7.
Not what you want to be seeing. She's gone for something absolutely outrageous there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what she was trying to do there, actually. She was trying to flick a cross-court drop in, or just the ball squirted up at her a little bit. I'm not sure. It was a little bit strange because you wouldn't see her normally try that kind of shot.
Yeah, it's extremely high risk. Wasn't really on.
Especially when you've just got yourself back into it.
Yeah, you'd think she'd be pushing on here and looking to make these elongate these rallies and almost do what she was doing to get those points and play a solid game, wait for Hana to take it in and then counterpunch and we'll make the error like that. I think that's when this Tanvi is going to have a lot of success here.
Yeah, I mean, Hannah's not really been tested in the opening two rounds, so anything she's kind of hit so far has either been clean winner. So if the ball's going to keep coming back and you're day three of the tournament, it might just take a little bit of adjustment for her to get used to, oh, this is coming back, not just going to be a quick winner and I go and pick up the next point and serve. Oh, that's nice.
But it's just, yeah, ruthless, isn't it? It's just not letting Tanvi get away with any loose balls around the front. Giving herself four game balls here. There's a better rally from Khanna there, though, making Hana do a bit more movement around the court, getting off the middle. Unfortunately, just gave her a bit too much space and time in that last shot and got away nicely.
As you can see here on the screen, a quick run of points there from Moataz at the start before Tanvi Khanna managed to get back into it. Hana, the second seed from Egypt, will start the second game. And let's see if she starts the second as she did the first.
Yeah, I think if Khanna can sort of eliminate that blistering start again from Moataz and get herself into this second game here, she might be able to do a bit better, but with the shot that quality, it's great length, great width. It'd be hard for her to do.
Yeah, she did well to get that serve back as well.
Yeah, it was a great serve straight into the nick.
I like the way Hana moves up the court so quickly and then gives herself so many options at the front. She can hit that straight drop, she can hold it and hit cross. It can just be so hard for Tanvi to cover all those shots and all these options. So she's so quick in position, didn't quite pick the right shot there, but...
Yeah, it's a great way of being deceptive, that, which I think sometimes the subtleties go unnoticed when you're watching the top level squash players, where they think deception has to be holds and flicks and sort of something different around the court, but actually you can be deceptive with your movement Like there, Hana was racing into the front of the court, looking like she was going to hit it really hard and just hit a nice soft backhand fade across the front. And it's very hard to read for your opponent.
Yeah, and again there, just quick in position and just whips around the post. And it also adds that little bit of extra pressure to Tanvi's shot because she knows then that Hannah's moving so quickly onto it that she might pull one down the middle or she might clip the top of the tin, knowing that that little bit of extra pressure of Hannah's movement is just causing a little bit of stress on her. Did well to play that because I thought she was going to ask.
She's not quite getting the lift she wanted out of that front forehand there.
No, so pretty similar to the first here. Hana racing off to a 7-1 lead and not really messing around here. That's a good shot from Khanna. Can she mount a comeback just like she did in the first? Well, that's a good counter drop in the front. Just the way she was able just to roll over her hand there just to control it to get back on the front wall.
Yeah, again, it's just she's got that lead now that she can just sit on and take this game at her own pace. Very dominant performance so far.
Oh, fantastic shot. What a drop shot into the front corner there. She's got a big spring in her step.
Oh.
Yeah. Just fantastic. She's just so early onto everything, taking it before the back wall again, just applying that little bit of extra pressure to Tanvi, and it's making life difficult at the moment.
Yeah, she's struggling to deal with this pressure at the moment, isn't she? It's just relentless quality from the Egyptian.
That was good. She did manage to get onto that ball at the front quickly then and hit it past Hana, but still 7 game balls to come here.
Yeah, I think in that rally, just her quality into the front was slightly better, meaning that she could read Hana and where she was putting the ball and allowed her to move a bit and hit a nice winner to the back of the court. Saving 2 game balls here, but still a long way to go.
It was interesting that body language there from Hana. She just looked like she just lost that little bit of a spring there. See if she can't sit back. She crunches that return and that. So it didn't take long for her to get that. Yeah, that came back very quickly. As we see there, another impressive run of points there for Hana Moataz in the mid part of that game. Quickly racing up to 7-2 and straight back onto court for the start of this this third game. What do you think, Owen, if you're coaching Tanvi at the moment?
I mean, it's a tough ask here to come back into this when Hannah's in this form, but I think Tanvi just maybe needs to cut out the angles and just sort of starve Hannah of any opportunities and try and hit some better lengths towards the back, straight and long, and really try and pick her off with perhaps a bit more patient squash. But at the moment, it's Hannah who's hitting the better length, not enabling Tanvi to do that. So it's going to be a real battle here for her, for Tanvi, to get back into this.
I agree. It's not going to be easy to get her back into this. But she, as you said there, she had a bit of a better chance when she lengthened out some of the rallies in that mid part of the first. Didn't really have an opportunity to do that in the second.
Yeah, it's just shots Hannah's like that. But... Sorry, go on.
No, I was just going to say, Hannah's obviously playing with a lot of confidence as well. So she's got to break that.
Yeah, I agree. I think in that first rally there, just Tanvi just chucking in a boast in the back of the court, which just didn't need to be hit. I think she needs to keep Hannah behind her as long as possible here. She's just so lethal from the front. I mean, you might get a few errors like she has in the last 2 points, but as a whole, she's being controlled. I can't afford to give her that time at the front.
That's not what we've seen so far. That's three errors this game from Hannah. Just
yes, almost a complete flip of what we've seen in two games.
We've been seeing a hit clean winners so far, and so it's just the rallies have got a little bit longer from Tanvi here. That is severe.
Yeah, you've got to be so quick and explosive to get that back. It's just the defence from the front of the court from Tanvi not quite giving her enough time to recover back to the tee. That's better. It's a good length. That's what she needs to do here to get some success.
Yeah, she just looked like she was going to hit that just above the tin and then just got it just below the mid-court, the service line there on the front wall, and just kind of pushed it through to the back of the box and found a much better length. Something for Hannah to think about, which so far she hasn't really had anything to think about so far.
Yeah, I don't think Hannah throughout the whole tournament has been behind by more than 2 points. So interesting to see how she'll cope with this deficit here, being faced with it for the first time.
That wasn't far away either. You can see from Hannah's reaction that she knew she'd left an opportunity there for Tanvi to hit that winner.
Yeah, I would have liked to see Tanvi just sort of keep that rally going there. I know you've got to threaten the short ball sometimes, but I think perhaps when you've got that 5-2 lead and your opponent's making a few errors and giving you a few more opportunities, perhaps just keep playing what you're doing and wait for that clear-cut opportunity. I felt like she forced that one a little bit, but she's got her 3-point lead back here.
Definitely don't want to be leaving the ball in that kind of area against Hannah there. So it's just, yeah, just had established a 3-point lead and then it's just quite quickly lost the next 2 points.
It just shows you how consistent you've got to be to beat these top players. Just two shots there where she perhaps mishit her length, didn't quite hit her targets, and she's getting punished for it. So she needs to try and get that a bit more consistent here, going into the back end of this third game now.
Almost caught the nick off the serve there. Oh, that's too good. I've seen quite a bit of that this week, of like someone hitting a really good drive into the back forehand and then stepping quickly across on the forehand side for the winner.
Yeah, I think if you can hit a low, hard, aggressive length on this court, you get rewarded for it. Because, like you said, there's some funny bounces coming out the back. On a glass court anyway, it's hard to do. But, and then she's getting rewarded but from her good shot by Tanvi returning the ball around that service box area. And that's your bread and butter for Hana there. She's tidying up nicely.
Yeah, I thought that was a wrong, yeah. That the last shot from Hana there, I thought that should have been a straight drive down the line, not the drop shot, because Tanvi was right up next to her. So all the space was at the back of the court then.
Might be the
seven. Go on, mate.
It might be the pressure there of her actually being behind towards the latter stages of this game here. Maybe she's not coping with it too well. She's just almost going lower and lower on that tin and making more mistakes rather than getting it back to where she was and asserting her dominance around the length section of the game.
Yeah, and it can be difficult, that, because, you know, this is semi-finals and she's played, this will be her third match, and she's only been on court 15 and 17 minutes. It can be quite hard to start your tournament really in a semi-final. Didn't need that really from there, Tanvi. She probably wanted to make that rally a little bit longer and a little bit harder, keep Hana under pressure. That's going to be a stroke.
She gets a stroke there. Yeah, it's just a bit disappointing to see her. You'd like to see a bit more discipline from Tanvi here on those points where she does just sort of elongate those rallies in crucial points and not give away the cheap mistake and let the Egyptian back in it. She's done that a couple of times this game already, and I think there's only so many times you're going to be let off and get away with that.
Yeah, you know, you've got Hana here under a bit of pressure. As you say, you don't want to just gift it straight back to her. You've got to keep building that pressure for what, four or five rallies continuous, and see what Hannah's made of.
Well, last game ball, see if she can convert it.
Just gets a little bit awkward when that ball gets into that back corner. Just kind of squirts out at you a little bit quick sometimes in there. Hana didn't fancy taking on that drop and she squeezed it. She's back in it.
There we are, just completely against the run of play in those first two games. She's managed to open up a lead at the start of that third game and hold on to it just 11-9 in that third. It's good for Tanvi. It'd be good if she can keep it going into the fourth game.
Here we go for game number four. The Egyptian leading 2-1. Tanvi having come back and won the third. Let's see if she can continue, as you said there, Owen, of extending the rallies and making things a little bit more difficult for Hana.
Yeah, she just got a little bit edgy towards that. Hana, that is, got a bit more edgy, started going a bit lower on those winning shots when she was under pressure and making a few more mistakes in that third game.
I don't think we're going to see any change of style though from Hana. I think she's going to keep going with the aggressive nature, and it's got to be Tanvi who's got to be disciplined to find good lines and length. Not the start that Tanvi wanted here.
Yeah, I think
I felt the line was probably to the left there.
Yeah, I think she was almost struggling to get there anyway and maybe saw the let ball as an out opportunity, but the ref is a bit wiser to that, given the no let, which I think was the correct decision.
Yeah, I think that's the first one we've all agreed on. That's not going to be a let either. That. Yeah, I felt that shot was too good there from Tanvi. Well, that is closer to the floor than the top of the tin, that one. Didn't quite make the adjustment quick enough.
Yeah, almost tried to do the full adjustment with her racket arm there and the racket face rather than moving her feet and getting into the correct position for that shot. Well, after the 4-love lead, Tanvi's got back into this now. It's a great winner there.
Yeah, pretty similar to what we saw in one of the matches last night, like big swings in momentum by both players. That's a fantastic boast from the half court area. Just so quickly how she whips it around the front. And Tanvi's quick as well, you know, it's not like Tanvi's slow, she's pretty quick and she didn't really see that to get going.
I think it's what you said, she just got in position so well there, and despite being in the back of the court, she got her body behind it, hit it with a really open stance, and it meant she could have hit a cross court or straight length, and opted for the boast, and absolutely ripped it around the corner, and yeah, it was hard to read that for Tanvi.
Oh, that's beautiful, that backhand drive, we've got a perfect angle to see that backhand drive almost die at the back of the court and set up that front court winner for Hana.
Yeah, I thought Tanvi did well to get that length back in the first place. It was, I mean, you could see it on the back wall. It was bouncing millimetres above the floor on the back wall. So she did well to get her racket underneath.
I was impressed with that pickup. But Hannah's not messing around. She's put a string of points together. 4-3 through to 8-3.
Yeah, I think she's found a range a bit. I think she might have, in a combination with a bit more pressure from Tanvi in that third game and perhaps seeing the finish line and going for too many winners, that was the combination which led to the Indian player winning that third game. But here she's got her base length back, hitting more aggressively into the back of the court, freeing up that space at the front, and it's been all the Egyptians' way so far. But Tanvi's not giving up.
Well, it's nice because she's pushed, she's just held that just at the top of the swing there a little bit. Looked like she was going to go short as she has done for most of the match and then just pushed it a little bit deeper. And Tanvi was just caught rushing to the front a little bit and then saw that it wasn't going there and tried to push back but couldn't quite get behind it and then skied it out of the court. Well, that brings up
really good squeeze that.
Brings up six match balls for Hana Moataz to make it an all Egyptian final tomorrow.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how she, if she does make it to the final. Obviously, no writing off anything yet, but it's looking very much like that. It'll be an all Egyptian final at the moment. Be interesting to see how she does play against Malak Kamal, because she's also an incredibly attacking player.
Yeah, it's a shame we didn't quite get the camera angle for that, because that looked a massive taxi.
We always love to see that.
Oh, there beautiful. That was really nice, that little backhand in the front there to finish it, because that was a tight drop shot from Tanvi, and she just managed to squeeze it off the sidewall for a little trickle bust winner in the front. So Hana moves on to